to give you a slightly better understanding of the differences between black box testing and white box testing, I'm going to provide you a couple of simple examples that illustrate the strengths and limitations of these two techniques. So in this case, let's start with black box testing. So we're only working with the specification. So let's say that our specification says that this is a program that inputs an integer value and prints it. And the implementation, we don't know, because we're working at the black box level. If we wanted to test this function according to its specification, what we will probably do is to select a positive integer, a negative integer, and the zero as test inputs, and see how the program behaves for these inputs. So let me now show you a possible implementation for this specification. What I'm showing here is this function that we called printNumBytes, which takes the parameter and prints it. And one thing that we notice right away is that although in the specification, numbers that are less than 1024 and numbers that are greater or equal to 1024 are exactly equivalent from the specification standpoint, they are, however, treated differently in the code. So the developer decided that the program was just going to print the value of the parameter if it's less than 1024, but it was actually dividing it by 1024 and printing it with a kilobyte mark after it if it were greater than 1024. And notice that here there is a problem. The developer used the number 124 instead of 1024. So there's probably a typo in this point in the code. So this is a case in which by simply doing black box testing, so by simply looking at the specification, we might miss this problem because we have no reason to consider numbers that are less than 1024 or greater than 1024. However, if we were to look at the code, so operate in a white box manner, we will right away see that we need to have a test case that checks the program when the parameter is greater than 1024, and we will find the problem right away. So now let me show you a dual example.